this is my vineyard, and we're standing and looking down north. This is Frontenac. These are four-year-old vines. They look pretty good size for four-year-old vines, but they've been taken care of very well. I'll show you the trellising system. Come over here to the corner post. These posts are 4x4x8 treated timbers, and they're 8 feet long, 2 feet in the ground, 6 feet above. And as you can see, the end anchors are ground, 2 foot long ground anchors, and they're screwed into the ground. They go in very easy. They even dodge boulders, believe it or not. And this wire, of course, is twisted and supports the ends. There are the first wire is 3 feet off the ground, and then we have a 6 foot wire here, and then another wire halfway, so a catch wire between there. These are the wire vices here. Now you just drill a hole in the post and they just slip right in, and they're secured by two nails. And you just use a hammer to pull those and tighten them. And come over here, and you can see that Frontenac this year, we have a big crop. And you can see at a lower angle, you can see the crop is, you know, between, some of it is only a foot off the ground, but most of the crop is around that first wire, which is 3 feet off the ground. You can kind of move over here and show the clusters there. Veraison has not happened yet. I expect that in another week or two. Let's move over here. I have four rows of Frontenac. I put in a sprinkler system this early spring because we managed to dodge a frost after bud break just about every year. It's so close, and I just didn't want to run the risk of losing a crop. And with just two nozzles, they're 12 feet off the ground, high pressure nozzles, I can protect 72 vines with just the two nozzles. The vineyard is square, so these are just kind of located centrally. I just did some summer pruning. We prune the vines so that the clusters are exposed to the sunlight. And then at the north end here, you can see our new planting this year of Marquette vines. And I know you're supposed to prune off the clusters, but I just didn't have the heart to do that. Not all of the 24 vines had flower clusters on them this year, but the ones that did don't seem to be stunted by the fact that they've got a cluster, contrary to popular opinion. Their vines are spaced 8 feet apart and 8 feet between rows. All the spacing I've ever used. And if you come down here and pan down here, you can see how the vines are spaced, and you can see the top wire hasn't been put on this last row of Frontenac yet. See, they could have used it. So we'll have to get that on maybe within the next few days. I've got a way of hoisting the wire up so that we can turn it easier. Just show you, just for the fun of it, the rest of the garden here. My tomatoes. Down there's cucumbers and pole beans, and the asparagus ferns that you see there are 7 feet tall. That's what happens when you put a spreader full of manure on every year. Gale Qualls has to get rid of his poop, so he brings a whole spreader full of manure over and we dump it on the garden every year. Got some pumpkin here and butternut squash. There's another 12 Marquette vines, and they're doing very well. I got them from Ray Winter, and all the vines I've ever bought were nice, with a few exceptions. But these these are the nicest vines I've ever planted. Ray Winter. They were all big, uniform, nice roots, and I planted them one day, and 3 days later, the shoots broke. So it was just perfect timing. They just grew like crazy. This row is the Frontenac Gris. And it's the same trellising, but trellising hasn't been tightened. I wasn't anticipating this much growth this year. I think the Frontenac Gris looks like it's almost overcropping. You can see a lot of clusters here. These vines are only 2 years old. This is the third growing season. And if you can kneel down there, Eric, and you can get a close-up of those clusters. A lot of grapes. But I've never heard of anyone having trouble getting good sugar levels with Frontenac. In fact, they're usually very high, but I don't know if they have to cluster thin to get that. We've had a little bit of trouble with leaf phylloxera this year, but I had some chemicals left over that you can no longer buy for the home gardener. And it just really, you know, you spray it on at the first sign of leaf phylloxera and it just stops it in its tracks. The only other disease you have to worry about with Frontenac is anthracnose. And if you do a lime sulfur spray before bud break, or I guess maybe even in the fall, I'm not quite sure about that, but if you do a lime sulfur spray, maybe in February or March, long before bud break, apparently that absolutely prevents anthracnose in Marquette. I don't know about that, or not Marquette, but the Frontenac. So I'll have to do a little more research on that. So if you use lime sulfur spray, it'll prevent it. If you get it, you can use either Nova or Furbam, I guess. But I don't have either one of those chemicals. And this year, with the dryness that we've had in the early summer, I'm not really all that worried about anthracnose. So I'll show you how the wires are just at three. This is the first level at 3 feet, and those are just wire nails. They're in U-shaped wire nails, and I alternate this side, the opposite side, and this side. And that's the trellising system.